इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग मेटल जॉइनिंग प्रोसेस पार्ट फोर। इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग, इन इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम वेल्डिंग प्रोसेस द हीट इज जनरेटेड व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इम्पिजेस ऑन वर्कपीस। एज वी हैव सीन इन अदर वेल्डिंग प्रोसेसेस, sometime there is a fusion, sometime there is a pressure. Based on these two phenomena we have learned the welding processes, but these are the different one. This use the new techniques, and by using that technique we do the welding in various metals. So how it works exactly? As the high velocity electron beams strikes the surfaces to be welded, their kinetic energy changes to thermal energy and hence causes the workpiece metal to melt and fuse. So as a velocity of this electron beams when strike to the metal, which responsible for welding, and this happens because of the kinetic energy of that electron beam when strike to the surfaces to be welded, their kinetic energy changes to thermal energy and which create the heat, and because of that heat workpiece metal is melt and also fuse. As I already told you, in this process there is no filler metal or flux is used because these are not a conventional welding processes. Let's see how electron beam welding works. So this is a vacuum chamber. Under this vacuum chamber welding is done. And why vacuum chamber is required? As the vacuum increases, the scattering effect of the electron beam decreases and hence penetration increases. It means that if you do this electron beam welding in a atmospheric condition, because of the atmospheric pressure as well as air pressure, the electron beam may be scattered, and because of that scattering it will not penetrate the metal, and due to which we will not get a desired welding. Secondary, weld metal is not contaminated. As we have seen in case of pressure welding, we use a certain fluxes in brazing also, soldering also, and in gas welding we use a gas, in TIG we use inert gases to protect the weld from contamination. Here we use a vacuum to reduce the contamination. Under this vacuum chamber there is a roller, and on this roller we kept a working table. On this working table there is a workpiece, and a viewing section is provided to monitor the process of welding. Vacuum pump is provided to increase or decrease the vacuum in the vacuum chamber. On the top of the machine there is a cathode grid is provided, and this cathode grid is made up of tungsten or tantalum, which is a hot filament and is the source of stream of electrons which emits electron by thermionic emission. So what is this thermionic emission? This term state that thermionic emission is the liberation of electrons from the electrode by virtue of its temperature. It means that this process is liberate the electron from this electrode by virtue of its temperature. So we will see in detail. The high voltage cable is connected to this cathode grid, which is in the range of voltage 30 kilowatt to 175 kilowatt, and very minimum ampere current is provided, that is 50 milliampere to 1000 milliampere. Below the cathode grid there is an anode is provided, and the function of this anode is to create the potential difference between this cathode and anode, which is 30 kilowatt to 175 kilowatt. Under that there are the magnetic lenses. The use of this magnetic lens is to shape the beam and reduce divergence of beam, and it allows only to pass convergent electrons. Under the magnetic lens there is a deflection coil, and this deflection coil helps to focus the electron beam at the spot. Now when we supply the current to this high voltage cable, a huge amount of current is provided to this cathode grid, which is made up of tungsten or tantalum, and when it receives the current its temperature is rising, and due to the increase in temperature this thermionic emission is started, and when this thermionic emission started, the electrons, this cathode grid start emit the electrons, and this electron try to flow from this negative cathode to this positive anode, and because of that there is a huge acceleration from this cathode to this anode of this electron. This accelerated electron when pass through this magnetic lenses, or when they hit to this magnetic lens, this divergent beam converted into convergent, this magnetic lens is responsible to convert them, and which flow to the deflection coil. When they reach to the deflection coil, it create the single beam and it strike on this workpiece. When this high velocity accelerated electron beams, which contains the huge amount of temperature, when they strike to the workpiece, this workpiece start penetrating. And because of this penetration, when this gets solidified, we will get our desired welding, and it happens continuously, and because of that we get our desired welding. To monitor the whole process, there is an optical viewing port is provided on the middle of this machine. Welding speed is in the range of 125 to 200 mm per second, and area which this electron beam covers is in the range of 0.3 to 0.8 mm, and velocity of this electron beam is 70% of light speed. Advantages of electron beam welding: vacuum environment eliminates impurities such as oxides and nitrides. These are great advantages of vacuum electron beam welding. Second is permit welding of refractory and dissimilar metal not weldable with conventional welding process. So we can join the dissimilar metal, but we cannot join the refractory metals, which is possible in case of conventional welding process. EBW, that is electron beam welding, has a high strength with the minimal distortion or damage. Disadvantage of electron beam welding is the size of components to be welded is limited by the size of vacuum chamber at your disposal. It means that the size of vacuum chamber decides the size of welding material. Second, safety standards are exceptionally strict, as X-ray and radiation are both present during the welding process. Application of electron beam welding. Bimetal slab blades are produced in large numbers by electron beam welding. It means that it used to make a bimetal slab blade. Transmission assemblies are frequently fabricated by electron beam welding. Aerospace component in titanium alloy are fabricated by electron beam welding. It is used to join titanium and its alloy. This is a great use of this EBW, that is electron beam welding. Thank you for watching this video.